In essence, potential transformers or voltage transformers consist of a core, a secondary winding, a primary winding, and the insulation. The voltage transformer will transform the high voltage applied to its primary winding to a low voltage on its secondary winding with the ratio on its nameplate. The secondary voltage vector differs from its ideal corresponding primary vector due to internal losses, such as copper losses and iron losses. Furthermore, the connected burden also affects the voltage ratio error and phase displacement. The amplitude error is negative if the amplitude of the secondary voltage is smaller than the amplitude of the ideally transformed primary voltage. If the secondary vector lags behind the primary vector, the phase error is negative. In order to compensate the ratio error, manufacturers sometimes adjust the number of primary or secondary turns. The majority of voltage transformers used today are either inductive VTs or capacitive voltage transformers. Capacitive voltage transformers consist of an inductive VT, a high voltage capacitive divider, and a compensating reactor. The compensating reactor is designed to resonate with the primary capacitances at rated frequency, helping to compensate the phase shift due to the high voltage capacitive divider. Different types of voltage transformers are being used depending on application and voltage level. For medium voltage levels, epoxy resin cast VTs are common. For higher voltage levels, oil and paper is typically used for insulation. Voltage transformers may also be insulated with gas or can be integrated into gas-insulated switchgear. They are used around the clock throughout the energy grid, and their lifespan can reach up to 40 years. During that time, the effects of aging, regular operation, network faults, or external influences may affect the integrity of a voltage transformer. Oil leakage, hot spots, winding deformations, short circuits, or moisture ingress are typical causes of voltage transformer errors. Harsh environmental conditions also affect the aging process. Defects may cause a voltage transformer to explode. Such explosions put the safety of utility personnel at risk and often damage surrounding assets. Utilities perform various tests during commissioning and maintenance in order to find any irregularities that have been caused by transportation, installation, or daily operation. The frequencies and methods used for conducting these tests vary greatly depending on the corporate and national policies. Typical equipment checks may include visual inspections, oil analysis, and electrical tests. Partial discharge measurements may be performed to verify the integrity of the voltage transformer. A detailed analysis of the insulation condition can be obtained through dielectric response measurements. Short circuits can be detected with ratio measurements. However, simple ratio measurements cannot be used to verify the accuracy according to the standards. The excitation voltage is too low, and the burdens defined in the standards are not available. The accuracy of the voltage transformer is important for a reliable electric power supply and correct revenue metering. Since the beginning of the 20th century, accuracy measurements have been performed at nominal voltage. During these measurements, the secondary voltage of the transformer is compared with the secondary voltage of a highly accurate reference transformer. Over time, these conventional approaches have been adopted for mobile use. Omicron's Vitana 100 uses a modeling approach. The modeling approach allows the accuracy to be verified by determining the elements of the voltage transformer's equivalent circuit and subsequently calculating the error. This approach increases the safety level of the personnel and reduces the amount of effort required. In factories, labs, and on-site, Vitana 100 has made testing voltage transformers economically feasible for many operators.